आज का हमारा टॉपिक है सेल द यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ। हमारे आसपास, हमारी सराउंडिंग्स, इसके अंदर हमें बहुत सारी वेरिएशंस मिलती हैं, बहुत सारी डाइवर्सिटी मिलती हैं। अब इस डाइवर्सिटी में हमने इस पूरे सिस्टम में दो चीजें देखी। एक है लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स और एक है हमारा नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स। और इन एनिमेट थिंग्स वी कैन हैव अ क्लियर कट डिफरेंसिएशन बिटवीन लिविंग एंड द नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स। एंड ऑब्वियसली व्हेन वी आर मेकिंग दिस डिफरेंसेस वी विल से द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर दोज विच कैन ग्रो, नॉन लिविंग थिंग्स दे डू नॉट ग्रो। बट कैन वी से दिस इज अ वेरी, यू कैन से ऑब्वियस डिफरेंस? बिकॉज सपोज आई से दिस इज ग्राउंड फ्लोर ऑफ वन बिल्डिंग। आफ्टर टू थ्री ईयर्स सपोज वन मोर फ्लोर इज कंस्ट्रक्टेड ओवर हेयर, one more floor is constructed over here. So what does this? This is also a sort of a growth. So how we are going to differentiate it? That this organism is growing, this or this building is also growing. Here the growth is differentiated because this growth is from inside. The organism is growing on its own, while here you are adding the materials over it, thereby the things are growing. In another example, suppose I have a rubber band. The size of rubber band is this, but when I stretch it, obviously it grows, it elongates. But the moment I release that stress, it will come back to its original size. So I cannot call that is a growth. But here, suppose I stop taking the food, can I come back to that size, the zero size? Can I come back to that single cell structure that is zygote? No. So this is one major thing. Another thing is that these living organisms, they are made up of cell. These cells are the structural and functional unit. These cells are structural and functional unit of the life. Suppose we are using this word. Why we are using this word structural? I want to make a house. I want to construct a house. What I require is the brick. Suppose I want to construct a shop. The basic thing which I require is again the brick. Suppose I want to construct a hospital. What I want is again the brick. So what I want to say here is, whatever the building I want to make, the basic requirement is the brick. This becomes the structural unit of any building. Likewise, whenever we say the living organism, we cannot imagine the life without cell. Therefore, we call cell as a structural unit. Now we come to the second part of it, that is the functional unit. This functional unit, it is in a cell, so many organelles we can find. because of these organelles, the cell is capable of doing the function. We cannot imagine the respiration without the mitochondria in the cell. Likewise, this cell, it is performing all the functions of the life. We can call this as the functional unit of the life. It is responsible for maintaining the homeostasis of our system of the life. So this is what we are saying, the unit of life, that is the cell. Now when we are studying the life, we call that branch biology. Likewise, when we are studying the cell, this branch is called as cytology. In this branch, we are studying the cell structure. But now, this particular branch is improved by studying not only the cell structure but also about the physiology of the cell, also about how the cell reproduces, also about how the cells undergo various reactions, or we can say the chemical constitution of the cells. So all these aspects we include, and thereby this is no more a cytology, it becomes a cell biology. It becomes a cell biology. Now in this field of science, the work is possible because of microscope. Because all these organelles, the cell, we cannot see with our naked eyes. These cells, if an organism is made up of a single cell, we call that organism as a unicellular organism. And if the organism is made up of several cells, we call that as the multicellular organism. Okay. Now, There is a lot of research done in this field. The credit goes to Robert Hooke. He was an English scientist. This is very important. He was an English scientist. He was also a member of Royal Society. That means he was a scientist. In the year 1665, with his primitive microscope, he observed. He prepared a very thin slice of a cork. This cork is, he has prepared this it from quercus. This is commonly called as Spanish oak. So when he prepared a thin slice of cork and he observed under the microscope, he found that there are these honeycomb like structures. And these honeycomb like structures, he gave the name cella, or we can also call it as cellulae. This is a Latin word. विच मीन्स एम्प्टी कंपार्टमेंट्स और एम्प्टी चैम्बर्स. रॉबर्ट हुक इनफैक्ट सॉ दिस स्ट्रक्चर एंड वी कैन कॉल इट एज द डेड सेल बिकॉज वॉट ही ऑब्जर्व वॉज द सुपराइज्ड सेल वॉल. ठीक है, इसने क्या ऑब्जर्व किया, क्योंकि अंदर का जो कंटेंट था वो सारा ड्राइड अप हो चुका था बिकॉज उसने कॉर्क लिया. अब ये कॉर्क क्या होता है, कॉर्क जो है वो एक लेटरल मेरिस्टेम है. लेटर ऑन यू आर गोइंग टू स्टडी व्हाट इज दिस मेरिस्टेम. लेटरल मेरिस्टेम है जिसकी वजह से प्लांट का डायमीटर बढ़ता है. नाउडेज we are using the plastic bottles and we are using the plastic lids, but earlier this cork was used as a lid. जो glass bottles हैं उसके अंदर हम इस cork को as a stopper use करते थे. क्यों? क्योंकि इसके इस feature की वजह से. Suberized क्या है, polymer है एक fatty acid का जो impermeable है वॉटर के लिए और एयर के लिए, मॉइस्चर के लिए. तो अगर हम इन बॉटल्स के ऊपर ये कॉर्क लगा देते थे तो ये इनपरमिएबल था, इसके अंदर वॉटर और एयर ट्रांसफर नहीं हो सकता, तो इसकी वजह से हम इसे यूज करते थे. तो रॉबर्ट हुक का ये ऑब्जर्वेशन था कि उसने स्लाइड्स पे क्या देखा, एम्प्टी चैम्बर्स. So, अगर हम देखें तो ये वर्ड जो हम यूज कर रहे हैं सेल, तो एक तरह से ये सेल क्या हो गया, ये हो गया हमारा मिसनॉमर. ये क्या हो गया हमारा मिसनॉमर, क्योंकि सेल के अंदर, तो अभी मैंने प्रीवियसली आपको बोला कि सेल जो है वो ऑर्गेनिजम्स की फंक्शनल यूनिट है. लाइफ के अंदर जितने भी फंक्शंस हमको करने हैं वो सेल के थ्रू होते हैं. कैसे, सपोज आई से अवर ब्रेन इज वर्किंग, सो कैन द सेल, कैन द ब्रेन वर्क विदाउट द न्यूरॉन? नो. व्हाई? बिकॉज न्यूरॉन इज ऑल्सो ए सेल. कैन आई से द लिवर वर्क विदाउट द हिपेटोसाइट्स? नो. सो दीज सेल्स आर फंक्शनल यूनिट. सो हाउ कैन वी से दिस एज द थिंग, द करेक्ट नेम फॉर इट? बट बिकॉज दिस वर्ड इज वेरी इजी टू प्रोनाउंस, वेरी इजी टू यूज, we are continuously using this word cell. This work was done in the year 1665. So afterwards there was another, you can say, discovery in this field, and that discovery was done by Anton von Leeuwenhoek. ठीक है, ही वॉज अ डच मर्चेंट. सो उसकी शॉप थी एंड ही वॉज वेरी फॉन्ड ऑफ ऑब्जर्विंग, ही वॉज वेरी क्यूरियस टू सी द थिंग्स एंड टू एनालाइज द थिंग्स. ही मेड हिज ओन माइक्रोस्कोप विच वॉज वेरी क्रूड टाइप, एंड वी कैन से अ वेरी primitive type of compound microscope. One day he was just observing the rain, and when this rain water was falling he collected the soil water and he just observed that water under his microscope, and what he observed was, you can say, unicellular organisms. And these organisms was named as wild animalcule. Later on, this wild animalcule was replaced by the term bacteria. So first he was able to see the free live cell. This is very important difference. when we are saying Robert Hooke's work, he has not observed a live cell. Basically, he observed a dead cell. Anton von Leeuwenhoek was the first who observed the free live cell. Later on, he observed sperm. He observed RBC. So, this was the work. While the work of Robert Hooke was published in his book called Micrographia. Now, the next topic is cell theory. This is very important from the examination point of view. In the year 1838, Matthias Sheldon he was a German botanist. He observed different plant cells. And he found that these different plant cells, they form the different tissues in the plants. Almost in the same time, that is 1 year after this, another scientist named Theodor Schwann. He was a British zoologist. While studying with the animal cells, he found that these animal cells, they are enveloped by a thin membrane. And this membrane is nowadays called as cell membrane or plasma membrane. Also, he compared these with the plant cells and he found that these plant cells and these animal cells differ with the cell wall. The plant cell has cell wall and the animal cells lack the cell wall. So this becomes the first postulate of this cell theory, that is, all the living organisms, they are made up of, all the living organisms are made up of cells and their product. But the main drawback of this theory was that this theory was not able to explain that how the cell came into existence. Later on in the year 1855, Rudolf Virchow explained omnicellulae, E-cellulae means every cell arises from pre-existing cell. So this becomes the second postulate of the cell theory. So if a question is asked, write a short note on cell theory. So what you have to do is mention about the work of Sheldon, mention about the work of Schwann, then this becomes the first postulate, that is, all the living organisms, are made up of cells and their products. And then later on in the year 1855, the statement given by Rudolf Virchow, that is, every cell arises from the pre-existing.